Friends, I would like to greet you and congratulate you because you are the pioneers that are helping ground 5D on planet Earth. So today's topic is going to be how to stay motivated towards the goal of 5D reunion with your twin, with your soul, with your higher self, and with the 3D soul self of your twin. Okay. Soul and higher self are one and the same here. Okay, so first you have to get the reunion with your higher self, which is your monad self, and then your twin awakens and his third dimensional polarized divine masculine soul merges inside you. Okay, so today I want to talk about what do you do when you feel sort of depression along this twin flame journey. You feel like reunion, physical 5D reunion with your twin flame is just not reachable for you. Okay, so let me just because this is one of the tougher journeys any human being can take, because this is the final journey. You know, I mean, this journey is given only to those people who are capable of it, and right now the evolution, spiritual evolution, is on an accelerated pace, and that is why a lot of people are meeting their twins. Okay, so a lot of people are reaching that pinnacle of evolution as a human being. Okay, because you have to evolve mentally, emotionally, physically, which we have all done. Okay, but somewhere as a species, as human beings, we are lacking evolution on the emotional and spiritual levels, and that is because there has been an interference in the sacred geometry of Mother Earth's grid. Okay, so the male energy, the patriarchal energy, was in excess, which created the imbalance. So the Merkaba of planet Earth was really set out of its place. You know, it was imbalance was created in the Merkaba of Mother Earth, of Mother Gaia. You know, a split was created in the spin of the divine masculine and divine feminine collective energies. That is why we see patriarchy and imbalanced masculine, which gives rise to physical development, mental progress, but lack of emotional and spiritual development. And what this causes, it causes issues with grounding of the divine feminine. So in such a Merkaba, in such a polarized patriarchal grid, the feminine cannot ground. You cannot ground feminine soul aspects, whether you are a male or whether you are a female. If you are a female and you're holding the feminine energy, you have to be a victim. You have to be codependent because the system pressurizes you. The system doesn't allow you to ground. The system makes sure that the feminine is not grounding on the planet, the true feminine. So that is the reason star seeds and twin flames were sent here to change the system so that we can allow the feminine to ground on the planet. Okay, the true feminine, because you see beautiful bodies around, but those beautiful bodies might not really be holding the true feminine energies. They could be holding the distorted, wounded, shadow feminine energies, you know. Just say, for example, there is a couple, okay? Or let's stress on the feminine for now. And I'm using this just as an example, okay? So there is this woman, she's holding beautiful feminine energies, but she's carrying a lot of karma with the divine masculine. So she's not able to attract a divine masculine in her reality. What she attracts is a shadow masculine because of the karma in her system. And then this shadow masculine puts blockages in her third eye, puts blockages in her heart chakra, sacral chakra, and, you know, basically wounds the feminine aspects, okay? So then what happens is the consciousness fragments, and let's just say in this situation, she's in a marriage with this shadow masculine, and she has no other option because the karma in her system is too much and it forces her to marry a karmic shadow masculine. So what happens? The soul splits. The feminine aspects are not loved, respected, so they leave. The soul is not able to ground the feminine aspects, and this woman, although being a woman, she will be holding the shadow mask, feminine energy. So what she will be doing is she will be basically taking her revenge on the shadow masculine. So she will be manipulative with her love, with her sexuality, with her even her spirituality, you know, and she will turn into the shadow feminine towards that masculine who has been controlling and abusive towards her. Okay, so this is how the masculine projects his wounds on the feminine, and the feminine projects her wounds on the masculine. So this becomes a really corrupted, evil system in which nobody is willing to do their work and heal. And that is why the twin flames were sent here, to teach people how to exist in harmony, how to heal oneself. It's all about, see, if you look at all the twin flame channels, what do they teach you mostly? DMDF, DMDF, divine masculine, divine feminine. This is the word, this is the term that is used most today. You look at the internet, and that is what was the agenda. We are right on track, because the awareness has to be brought towards these two energies and balancing them within an individual to end your marriage problems, to end your relationship problems, to end all your goddamn problems. Okay? Because it is when these aspects are wounded that you perpetuate the 3D matrix, you know, and all the issues and all the pain and all the sicknesses, diseases are born, are created. So the twin flames incarnated, they went through this long separation phase, and they are going through it to transmute the karma and to teach others through their own life experience how we do it. Look, we took on the same challenges, we took on the worst challenges. But with the help of spirituality, with the help of Kundalini, how do you transmute the karma? And when the twin flames descend, I'm telling you, divine grace descends. Because by their own awakening, their own Kundalini, they also awaken the Kundalini of the planet, of the collective. It becomes very easy for other people to have Kundalini awakenings, you know. We are here with the mission to free the souls. And if you bring this kind of awareness, and if you really absorb this knowledge, now guys, Kundalini will awaken, because we are activating your DNA. The moment you hear this true knowledge, which 10-15 years back you could not hear, even after attending so many inner this and inner that programs, you know, you had to pay so much for this knowledge, and now we are just asking you to donate a little bit to the channel, and you all are hesitating even to do that. So you observe the karma because of which the knowledge was hidden from you, because when the knowledge is given to you, you all don't give back. Okay, so this is how the karmic system works. Okay, because when the knowledge is given, you have to also absorb it, respect it, and you have to also give back. Okay, and previously this knowledge was not available, but for us, we just do it unconditionally. Okay, those who are guided to give back will give back, those who are not won't, and that is okay. But we have to do what we have to do, because it comes back to us in some or the other way. So the divine masculine, divine feminine has to be brought into balance so that we stop projecting our own unhealed traumas on each other. Okay, and now you have awareness about karmic relationships, you have awareness about soulmates, you have awareness, you have the light within you, you have the light among you, you know how to come out of it. Me myself, 8 years back, 7 to 8 years back, I used to spend days just to get one piece of information. The information was not out there. Okay? And now I'm blessed with a Kundalini awakening because I'm a twin flame incarnation. And I get the knowledge. I just have to raise my Kundalini. I have to meditate. And I get the downloads. I get the knowledge. And then I share it with you. Okay? So what do we do if we feel hopeless and depressed along this twin flame journey? Guys, I want to remind you of one fact. Every time you feel hopeless regarding your union, I want to bring you back to the fact that you are not doing your spiritual ascension work. Only when you are not doing the spiritual ascension work, only when your focus shifts from your ascension goals to your 3D material desires, that's when you feel lonely, that's when you feel hopeless, that's when you feel demotivated, that's when you feel depressed, that's when you feel you're not on the right track. Because you get into attachment, this is a journey that will beat you into teaching you detachment. It will beat you till you learn detachment. You will be beaten into learning detachment here. Because attachment is an illusion. There is nothing out there. Everything exists inside you. And once you can achieve it inside you, inner union, inner stages, completing the stages, completing number one, stage one. Now look, I'm telling the stages. Okay. First, you have to complete the soul merge with your monad self. Then your twin awakens. And then his 3D soul self merges inside you and you become one being. Okay. And if your twin doesn't awaken at that point, if his Kundalini doesn't awaken and if his karma is not cleared, then there are other options which I can talk about later on. But the reunion does happen. Okay. Because if you are a twin flame incarnation, you're not going to get stuck here. Another factor I want to remind you of is, if you do daily sadhana, you will be so much in contact with your higher self. Whether you are a twin flame incarnation or whether you are a human being who has found a twin flame and you have earned that level that you can magnetize your twin flame to you, whoever you may be, whichever level you might be at, okay, on the spiritual journey I'm talking about, here at this place, okay, you just simply need to stay focused. Okay, you have to stay focused on the spiritual path. The moment your eyes drift from the ascension goal to the 3D matrix, physical reality, will I get my physical 5D reunion? What will happen in the physical reality? No, your goal is shifting into the Maya matrix. Stop focusing on the Maya. Stop giving the power away to the Maya. You take the power. You stay focused on your soul embodiment process. Okay? And that is the cure to your feeling of hopelessness along the journey. So whoever you might be, whether you are a twin flame incarnation or whether you are a normal person who has found the twin flame. Okay? You need to be focused. Okay, this is the way to go. because this whole twin flame journey is about understanding the matrix. And just look at me, I was attacked, you know. I was attacked on my face, on my mouth. I have stitches in my mouth. Why? Because I'm spreading the truth of the matrix. I'm telling how their mind fucking system works so that you are not mind fucked by the demons. Okay? And then that's how they attack me, you know. Okay, fine. I think those who are really committed to the journey will just gear up the progress, because if you have that feeling of comradeship with the twin flames, if you are a twin flame, if you are a starseed, you will just shift the next gear. Okay? And if you want to succeed in this ascension mission, all of you who have the mission of ascending planet Earth, if any one of our members is attacked, you have to double the effort you put into the journey, because your goal is samadhi. You have to achieve the third eye samadhi, because at the third eye, the demons cannot infiltrate your system. That is the goal. Okay, and we have to do this for each other, because if you don't do this for each other, okay, they are going to separate us and attack individually. If one member is attacked, we have to all gear up our forces, our spiritual practices, and make sure we achieve samadhi. There are so many options to do that. There is Kriya Yoga. Go and find a good Kriya Yoga teacher. There is understanding celibacy. The moment you maintain celibacy and you do the inner work both simultaneously, your kundalini rises, you can achieve samadhi. There is daily practice. I mean, if you can achieve your material goals, why can't you achieve your spiritual goals? You can achieve anything. As a human being, you can become a god. If you have the knowledge, if you have the determination, and if you have the fight inside you. As for me, as for twin flames, we don't have a choice. We don't have a choice. We have to complete the spiritual goals. My 3D soul self wanted to step back a long time ago, but I couldn't. I was not allowed to. And whatever pain, whatever attacks you might go through, you have to also remember that these are part of initiation into your masculine, because the masculine is about courage. Okay, so if you're holding the masculine energies, you have to pass certain tests, certain initiations, which will require you to face danger, which will require you to work your ass off, which will require you to reach the peak of intellectual understanding, which will also require you to have strength, just pure strength. So balancing the masculine means achieving all these initiations, you know what I mean? So wherever you are on the spiritual path, if you want to be free, if you want to be liberated, guys, you have to achieve the samadhi, the third eye balance, you know. And I'm so happy to see that nowadays this is taught to children. There is a course that teaches how to open the third eye for children, you know. There are many such courses. There are beautiful people out there. There are beautiful communities out there which instill this knowledge. It's called something like midbrain yoga or something like that, okay? And in a very young age, they train the energetic flow to create the brain hemispheric merge. But the problem is, if you have a lot of ancestral karma, you'll never come across such people. You'll never be able to attend such courses. And even if you attend such courses, it will be damn hard for you and the child, whoever has this negative karma, to open the third eye or activate the midbrain. Because just the load of the shit of the ancestral karma is so much. And if you are a twin, then it's a lot. Because you take on all this shitload of ancestral karma so that you can be an example that, okay, if I can do it, you can do it. Tomorrow people shouldn't be able to say no, but you didn't go through this challenge. So that's why we have taken on all the challenges. To tell you that, wait a minute, I had that too. I experienced that too. You tell anything, I have experienced it. Because you're supposed to be at that level, you know. Only then you can help other people with their issues. And it doesn't mean as a twin flame you have to go through everything and know everything. Each twin flame pair has a certain specialty area. Like for me, it is relationships. For some other people, it is kids. Understanding children, the psychology of children, bringing up children, parenting. That is their area. That is their mission. For some people, it is research, scientific research. For some people, it is space exploration. For some people, it is health and medicine. Okay, each pair has a certain job. So if you are depressed along the twin flame journey, if you feel hopeless, ask yourself, am I achieving my spiritual targets? Am I achieving my spiritual goals? And one more factor, very important factor, is whether you are see, most incarnated twin flames, they will marry their twin because they have that mission that they have to stay together in a physical relationship, because there is work to do. It's very important for them to be physically living together. So they have the contract of marriage. If there is moksha in your soul contract and you are a twin flame, then the physical reunion is a must. It is a done deal. It is a guaranteed. But if you're talking about a wanting to marry your twin flame, you have to first figure out, what is my soul contract? Maybe it's just a fancy idea in your mind, you know, and maybe that's not what your soul wants. Maybe your soul is interested in some other mission for the collective, and after you transcend your karmic relationship, maybe a beautiful soulmate is waiting for you. There's nothing wrong with that. Okay, you have just not chosen the moksha contract. Because if you are a twin, if you have met your twin, or if you are a twin, or if you are an incarnated twin, or if you are a starseed, if there is a moksha in this lifetime for you, then there is also physical reunion for you. Okay, and not all starseeds are twin flames. Twin flame is a separate race. You know, the split, how that is a separate race, I feel. Okay, every person has their twin flame. Yes, they do have their twin flame. But some people, when they incarnate, they are born in quite a balanced state. Okay, they are not split into masculine and feminine. They are not split into divine masculine and divine feminine. Okay, they are just born whole. So does everyone have their twin flame? Yes, they do have their twin flame. Okay, but not everyone is born with that polarized half self, you know, where the other aspect of you is completely unconscious, because there is karmic blockages and that aspect is separate from you. So guys, I want to encourage you that if you're achieving your spiritual goals, then there is no need to feel depressed. There is no need to feel hopeless. Because the moment you achieve third eye balancing, the moment you achieve the 60-70 brain hemispheric merge, you start feeling your twin with you all the time. And when you start feeling the twin with you all the time, the external reunion has to happen. in whatever form that you want. If you are looking for marriage, it will happen as a marriage. If you are looking for friendship, it will happen as a friendship. If you are looking for a professional partnership to work with your twin on some project, it will happen that way. If you are looking just for a relationship with your twin without a marriage, it will happen that way. As long as there is no kind of perversion, because perversions don't exist in twin flame reunion, separation will happen. A lot of people speak about having multiple partners, like you are married to your maybe karmic, and then you also want to be with your twin flame, and then there is some other person you want to be with. That is just a perversion, I feel. And that is abuse of power, I feel. So once they get a certain level of acceptance in society, a certain level of social status, some people tend to abuse their power. And then it will turn out like one of those Osho communities, you know. See, human beings know, they have a keen sense of what's right and what's wrong. And the sex cult that was going on with Osho, they were kicked out of the US. They were kicked out of the US. First they were kicked out of India, then they went to US, they were kicked out of US because they were spreading perversion. I'm not saying Osho didn't do some good things. He broke the established powers, and you know what he did was amazing, what he did was great, but you know, there was some abuse of power going on there. Because if you look at Osho, they were all wearing red, and red is the root chakra energy, and probably it was polarized root chakra energy, the same thing that the matrix twin flame holds. And polarized root chakra energy tends to go for multiple sexual relationships because they want energy from several women, they want energy from several feminine sources, supply. You've heard the term narcissistic supply, so something like that. Because they are holding polarized energies, and such people know their third eye is not balanced. They may be connected to some negative energies, and those negative energies, see guys, here I want to tell you that even negative energies can open your third eye. Okay, there are many types of asuras that grant powers of opening third eye. So just like you can be initiated by a spiritual master, your kundalini can also be risen. I'm not sure whether your kundalini can be risen, but you can be given powers of occult powers, and you know, powers of vision by many negative entities. So you really do not know if somebody is powered by divinity or is powered by demonic forces. You don't know. You just have to stay connected to your heart and find out whether this spiritual path or this spiritual group is for me or not. You know, so I was a fan of Osho at one point, but not as a fan. I used to just I wanted the knowledge. And he gave little knowledge in around 70-80 books that he created. And I bought all of those books, and I got this knowledge at that time in the year 2000, and it was 2006 or 7, yeah, when I got interested in Osho. So today I realize what his whole game was about. And the most dangerous thing I felt about the Osho community was that negativity was hidden underneath the, on the last layer, you can say, you know, like food is served, tasty food is served, but the last layer is containing the poison. It was like that. They had beautiful ideals mixed with poison ivy, you know, because their whole thing was about abusing sex. Okay. And if you create such psychic cords, then your kundalini can never rise. And how many people have activated their kundalini in the Osho community? None, because they're sleeping around with multiple partners. Okay, so kundalini requires the elimination of lust, guys, you know, and you have to come to that stage where you eliminate your lust. And if you come to that stage with such methods of sleeping around like dogs, I mean, it's not very respectful of a human civilization, you know. So, because there has been footage of orgies that were taking place in the Osho community, you know, totally disgusting. Maybe it was some form of healing, catharsis. I can understand that as an intellectual, but if I look at it from an energy healer's point of view, it will just create unnecessary psychic cords, because when you have sex with somebody, their karma and your karma gets mixed, you know. So these things were never talked about, the energetic impact of sleeping with so many unhealed people, damaged people, you know, their illnesses can become your psychological illnesses. I'll give you an example. It's a simple thing. If somebody is cooking the food with stress, that stress affects the food, it affects those who eat the food. Okay, if that can affect, imagine how much sleeping with some sick patient can, I mean, psychologically, mentally ill people, depressed people. If you sleep with such people who come to the community, you will get their illnesses. They might get better and leave, but you will become sick. So there are many implications of sleeping around, you know. So let's come back to the twin flame journey. I was talking about achieving that state where you feel one with your twin, where you have merged your soul with your monad self, and you feel their presence, you feel the sacred sexuality with your twin flame. You feel their presence, you hear them, you hear them. Like right now, I can hear my 5D twin. He tells me about people's intentions. That was supposed to be a joke. But guys, I really hear him. And he tells me people's intentions towards me. He tells me people's agendas. He protects me. I feel the energy, you know, and when you reach this stage, you know that physical 3D reunion is inevitable. Okay, and for those who are not having the marriage contract with your twin, you will be presented with a soulmate. But if you have completed the soul merge, you know, your 5D twin has merged inside you, 60-70 merge has happened, third eye is open, and your kundalini is staying raised in your crown, it's circulating through your system. You are a living God. You know, you are an incarnation. If you have achieved that level now, then you mostly cannot be with your twin, cannot be with any soulmate. You know, you have to be with your twin. And either you live your life alone, okay, maybe you start a commune, community, whatever, and you live your life alone, because, or you marry your twin. But mostly you cannot have a sexual relationship with any other than the other half of your soul. If you have achieved the mukti. So guys, this was the video that I wanted to make to encourage you. Okay, every time you feel hopeless or depressed, it is because you're not focused on the spiritual goals. There is some or the other obstacle. So if you feel guided to, you can donate to my channel. Otherwise, you can just like my video, share my video, subscribe to my channel. And comment below, share your experiences. Alright. And I will see you again next time. Bye for now, and stay focused on the spiritual goals. You have to take back your power from the demonic agents by achieving samadhi. Figure a way. Bye for now, guys.